Well, the lone gunman in the temple shooting, Wade Michael Page, apparently had ties to white supremacy groups for decades. One of his fellow soldiers at Fort Bragg, Fred Lucas, came out front earlier, and I spoke to him on the phone from Bloomington, Indiana. I asked him how and when he knew about Page's radical views.
You could just see the, you know, his the shaved head haircut that he had, the vehicle he drove, and he was not, he had no problems telling people about his feelings about racial equality and such, or lack thereof.
So you also mentioned his car. What about his car stood out to you?
Well, it was a VW Thing, which is a 1960s era Volkswagen that very much resembles like a German military vehicle of World War II. And the it was orange, and he had, you know, darkened it up to red, and the red and the black tires with white walls, it just kind of evoked the symbology, you know, via color that you see in the Nazi flag.
Fred, was this something at the time you talked about with other people, other colleagues of yours, about him specifically, or sort of stuff that you heard that created this impression in you that he was a supremacist, but you never really talked about openly at the time?
I did, but there was, and I, my biggest regret is that I did not pursue it more. I was fully engaged, you know, with leading my own soldiers, that I didn't take the time to try and fix issues on other teams.
And so, Fred, when this happened and you first heard his name, what was the feeling that, how did you feel?
It was terror. I mean, honestly, I was driving when I heard this. It came over the radio, and I almost wrecked my vehicle. And but then, you know, after a little bit of reflection, it in some respects didn't surprise me.